What a tremendous pleasure it is to be back in the Philippines, first of all, but to be here today for this event. It's something that I and our Minister of Foreign Affairs, Chrystia Freeland, who I think has been chatting with you already, have been very, very excited about, because Canada over the past couple of years has really made a deliberate focus on women's empowerment. And that happens a lot of different ways, whether it's through a Canada Child benefit that is helping a lot more women with that work-life balance that we know women struggle with far more than men, because our society is just that way and still needs to evolve, or whether it's looking at encouraging women to get into science, technology, engineering, and math, and into areas in education that we know are extremely important and advancing, or mostly through women's economic empowerment, through looking at entrepreneurship, looking at reducing barriers for women's success in the workforce, looking at wage gap disparities, looking at how we can ensure that women are successful. And one of the things that we've taken on both at home and around the world is a feminist approach, which I know the word feminist still scares a few people, but it simply means recognizing that men and women are equal and should be equal, and second, that there's still an awful lot of work to do to get there. If you can say yes to both of those things, guess what? You're a feminist. And that approach, particularly when it comes to international engagement, is something that Chrystia and I have been working on very strongly. A feminist approach to foreign policy in general, but very specifically, a feminist approach to international development policy. Because it's not just the right thing to do, which of course obviously it is, but it's also the smart thing to do. We all know that empowering women to be successful is not just a single driver of economic success. It leads to compound effects as the community does better, as the village does better, as the entire economy of the country does better, the more women have pathways to success. And that's why I'm very, very excited today to be joined by these three extraordinary women who will be able to share their story and illuminate me a little bit on the challenges faced here in the Philippines, but also the pathways to solutions. So I'm really looking forward to it. I'm not going to take up more time for an introduction. I want to hear from Jeannie, from Zara, and from Anya, and we're going to get into it.